So today we are going to discuss about the back pain or the back injuries in the fast bowler. So if you are a fast bowler and if you want to remain injury free, so stay tuned. Hello and welcome to our new video in the series of strength and conditioning for cricket fast bowler. So today we are going to discuss about back pain or the back injuries, which is again the most common problem in most of our fast bowlers. So let's see why exactly back problems do occur and how to fix them and what will be the exercises in order to prevent your fast bowlers from getting injured. So when it comes to fast bowling, as we have discussed in our previous videos also in this series, that fast bowlers are majority of the times they are in that external rotation and come into the circumduction movement during the ball release phase. So this movement which pulls their arm behind and then has to pull it ahead in order to give a good bowling velocity, that is the time when fast bowler gets into the lateral flexion. So if you have a right-handed fast bowler, the back pain or the injury will be most common on the left lower lumbar region. So we will just see that when you have to check why your fast bowler is having any injury, you have to just see a quick assessment. That is, you have to ask the athlete to come down, that is the extension and lateral rotation. Because when they are going to get into the ball release phase, they are into the extension and lateral rotation. So if your bowler gives you a pain in this movement, that means yes, his pain is because of the recurrent fast bowling movement, and this usually happens because of the less amount of warm up or because of the longer spells of bowling. I will not say that don't go for a longer spells of bowling. Yes, that is absolutely required. Even your skill coaches will be for that. But you have to consider a most important part, that is the strength endurance of these lower lumbar region muscles. So these here you have your quadratus lumborum on the lateral side, paraspinal muscle and multifidia or erector spinae muscle group. So we have to work on the strength as well as building up a good endurance of these muscles in order to prevent your fast bowler from having a back injury. Next, another assessment you have to do, because most of the fast bowlers will have some or the other hip stability problem. So the one over here we understand it is the degenerative process which sets in, and the second thing is the stability. For stability, you will ask your fast bowler to stand in a single leg stance position. Just take your arms down and stand in a single leg stance position. Now when your bowler stands in this position, your eyes should be whether in both the ASIs are in the straight line or no. Majority of the times when there are hip stability issues, can you see the ASIs over here and the ASIs over here? One ASIs is down and the one ASIs is up. So that is the most common problem, which suggests that the hip stability component is also affected. The third quick assessment which we'll be doing is ask your athlete to sit down. Both the knees together slightly, yeah, with the hip width apart, and your both the arms will go just behind the neck. And ask your fast bowler to rotate the trunk in either of the direction. Can you see this? This is the range from the right side, move in the other direction. This is the range on the left side. So from this position, you will understand that whether hip and trunk mobility is compromised or no. And then accordingly you can give preventive or the prehab exercises for your athlete. So for a summary, so let's see a quick summary of it. First thing, you will be asking your athlete which movement is giving him pain. Usually it is extension and lateral rotation. Secondly, you will be checking whether the hip stability is compromised. That you can assess by giving a single leg stance. And the third most important is whether the mobility component is compromised or no. That you can do by the third assessment by sitting on the chair without moving the hip in this position. Majority of the times when you push them in the another dimension, your athlete might show this trick movement. So this movement should be avoided while checking the ranges of the upper torso. So as we discussed about the back injuries, now this problem usually happens with the fast bowlers who are having mixed bowling action, like when their shoulder girdle and hip girdle are moving in the opposite direction or they are not in the sync rate. That's a mixed bowling action. The second most important cause of this back injury is weak strength of the back extensors as well as the trunk stiffness, which we discussed last time. And another most important is there are some or the other trigger points which do get formed in the paraspinal muscles as well as in the quadratus lumborum, which can give you the pain. So you have to find out what exactly is the reason for your fast bowler for having the back injury, and then we can feature pain exercises which we have to consider in the prehab program for our fast bowler. So in this position, the athlete self in a lunge position, delivery stance leg goes ahead, that is this front leg, and the right leg goes into complete stable lunge position. Arms completely extended, holding the barbell in this manner. Now in this movement, he is going to take the barbell. Now consider he is a right arm fast bowler. He will be taking that barbell towards the left side first, maintaining the extension and the lateral flexion of the back. Just see how it goes now. Yeah, can you see this? This is the extension and the lateral flexion. Take it up completely. Yeah. This you have to repeat it with the other side as well, because we don't want the asymmetries to set in. So there should be a good range on the bowling side as well as to the non-bowling side. One more time. Nice. Now as we have seen the variation with the barbell, we are going to have one more variation where we are again focusing on the explosivity, but at the same time we will be having the repetitions, we will be keeping the repetitions of this exercise more in order to improve the strength and endurance component of our athlete. So in this position, the athlete is again lunge position with the medicine ball in his arm, and he is going to mimic the lateral rotation, lateral flexion and extension of the spine, and is going to explosively throw the ball. So where the strength and the power component comes, as we said, keep the weight of the medicine ball pretty low so that we can work on more number of repetitions in order to get a good outcome in the endurance quality. We'll see how it goes. Yeah. Nice. One last. Nice. Repeat these movements from both the sides, that is the bowling side as well as from the non-bowling side. As we said, we have to work on the symmetry of our athlete as well. So these were all the two mandatory exercises which has to be there in a fast bowler strength and conditioning protocol in order to prevent him from any back injuries or any recurrent back pain. So to summarize the complete content, we have to focus on the warm-up of the fast bowler before he is going for any matches or events, because by warm-up we are going to not only loosen up his muscle or make them prepare, but we are going to activate all the muscles of his body, which is going to be helpful for good stability. And the second most important thing we have to keep in mind while training a fast bowler is to monitor or keep an eye over their bowling spells, how long they are bowling. Here again, I would not say that the bowling spell should not be longer. It is, yes, definitely we have to focus on the longer bowling spells during the in order to improve the athletic performance. But I would only recommend gradually progressing the bowling spells. If the athlete is just at the beginner level and you're giving him high intensity bowling spells, that will lead to back injuries and back problems. So go on increasing the bowling spells step by step. Definitely the athletic progression will be better and the performance after update will improve. So if you have liked this content, then do make an effort to click on the notification bell icon, because in our next video we are going to discuss about the knee injuries for our fast bowlers. So stay tuned. Till then, take care and bye.